Hey y'all, today Cris and I are out camping with Aunt Lou and her family, and we're gonna make some Mississippi chicken and noodles in our Ninja Foodi.
All while having a whole lot of fun.
Woo! That is good.
Kitchen. We are here today to make some Mississippi chicken and noodles, pressure cooker style, in the Ninja by Foodi, which you guys have been asking us to show you how we've been cooking in this thing, and we're kind of in love with it a little bit.
So far, now we said once we got it, and this wasn't too long ago, we said, hey, we'll give you updates as we go and give you a final review on this product. So far, we don't use much other gadgets in our house, except maybe for the Ninja Foodi. Now, y'all know we've got like 30 different slow cookers, and we do use them. But when you get a new toy, you tend to want to play with the new toy all the time.
You have to clarify to them, though, because on the channel, you guys are seeing videos we've been taping all summer long.
Yes.
So that's why you haven't been seeing the Foodi.
So you've been seeing the Ninja
all-in-one
a lot. You've also seen our Cuisinart a lot, because those are the ones we tend to gravitate to.
Yes.
But
and
you're gonna
seeing a lot of this in our travel vlogs, too, because we'll show you little snippets where it may not be a full-on recipe, but we'll show you snippets of us using it, too. But today, we're going to get down to business. We are going to take 3 pounds of frozen chicken thighs.
Did you hear that? Frozen.
Frozen chicken thighs.
If you had thawed, you don't have to go freeze them up. Sorry, it's so hot, I can't think about how to say frozen.
Well, the timing will be different if it's not frozen.
Yes, but this is the one time when we're going to say you can cook chicken from frozen.
Well, you can do that anytime you use a pressure cooker because you're getting up to the heat faster.
Yes, and if you're gonna put down in the comments, you can't cook frozen chicken in a slow cooker or a electric pressure cooker, I'm just gonna tell you one thing right now. Let it go. Get it? Because it's frozen.
Okay, so for those of you who are following along at home, we are using, like I said, we are using 3 pounds of frozen chicken thighs. We are using this in our 6.5 quart pressure cooker, so this is going to fill this up quite a bit, but I do believe, because we've made chicken and noodles before, in our 6 quart Instant Pot and our 6 quart Crock Pot Express, that you can probably fit that in there. If not, you might take a little bit of the chicken out. So we are going to put in a bag of frozen noodles. This is a 24 ounce bag of frozen noodles. So there's that. If you don't want to use chicken thighs, we have a chicken and noodles recipe that uses chicken tenders that we really, really like.
Now, I want to ask you this.
Yes.
Oh, great Instant Pot and slow cooker guru, because I've had a lot of people say, hey, we can't find frozen noodles anywhere in our store. We use Reams. Now, Reams has done some sponsored work with us before, or we have done sponsored videos, but this one is not because Reams is sponsoring us. They're not. It's just we are confident in their frozen noodles. We like them for anything we do with the noodle recipe.
Yep.
But a lot of people said, hey, I can't get frozen noodles in my store. Can I use egg noodles?
I don't know, because I haven't tried it, because we use these all the time. We don't typically. So the answer is I don't know.
I have an answer. What I would do is I would cook the chicken, and then after the chicken is completely cooked, and you've got that broth in there with that chicken, that's when I would add the noodles and cook it down for about
sauté
feature for about 20 minutes. That will boil your noodles. But I would be sure and stir it, because you don't want the noodles or the chicken burning on the bottom of that pot when you're doing the sauté feature. So yes, you can use dry egg noodles, or you could use my mama's homemade egg noodles if you want to. I'll put the link down below for that. Or if you can, well, I'd say use Reams, but the wind just blew by and got the bag, so
the
Aunt Lou's throwing it away. Oh, here's it, right here. Yeah. Reams, there you go.
Yes, and so we can put I think we have a store locator that we've used before with them, for those of you that are looking for it. But anyhow, back to the recipe. We are going to add 1/4 cup of butter, and that is just a half a stick of butter.
Stick.
We are going to add a ranch packet. You know us around here, we love the chive and onion, so that's what we're going to use. You can use regular ranch, you can use the dill is very good with it too. We're going to add a packet of the au jus gravy.
If you want to use brown gravy mix instead, we won't stop you.
Mm-hmm. And so to that, we are going to add 4 cups of chicken broth.
That is one container, 32 ounces of chicken broth.
So we're just spraying all of this over the top.
I will de-stem these.
Okay.
Oh. All over the Ninja Foodi.
And so now Mikey's going to add pepperoncinis to the pot to taste six, or sometimes he adds
six
more.
Is the norm. That's going to make it where you get more of the sour than the heat from the pepperoncinis. If you like a little more heat, add more pepperoncinis.
Okay, since we're taking this from frozen, we're going to put this under high pressure for 10 minutes and let it naturally release. What we're going to do, and everything is just blowing around.
Yeah, the wind's blowing the mic. We're sorry. We're camping.
I'm.
What do you got? Is that five?
Yep.
Four. One, two, three, four. That's four. Five.
One, two. Okay. So what we're going to do, if you guys are familiar with the Ninja Foodi, it has a pressure cooking lid, which is what we are going to use. So it's going to operate like any traditional electric pressure cooker.
I like seven.
You are making
such now we're
mess.
Good.
So we won't be using the crisper lid that is attached to it. So that's why you see me grabbing a totally different lid over here. Are you done? Okay. So what we're going to do is we're going to have to take this off camera to plug it in. We're going to plug it in back there, which isn't on our camera set right now. And I'm going to put it under pressure for 10 minutes. And we'll be back after it naturally releases, which will take about 15 minutes. So...
I just ate a pepperoncini, so I'm going to take that time to go drink some water, and we'll be back in 3, 2, 1.
And we are back. We have let this cook under high pressure for 10 minutes. It took it quite a while because there was a lot of frozen stuff in there.
And we plugged it into our RV along with 2 other slow cookers for other recipes we did, and, well, we blew a fuse. Because evidently when you run 3 slow or 2 slow cookers and like a pressure cooker at the same time, you're going to blow a fuse. Like, I don't know if you've ever seen Cris blow a fuse, but it's bad. Anyway, we got everything working.
Yes. So we actually, here's pro tip for RVers. We plugged it in back there on the actual breaker.
Yeah. Because usually there's like a spot for like a 30 or 20 amp thing. And then there's also plugs at the bottom.
Yeah.
We use the plug. Worked out just fine.
Okay. So this cooked under pressure for 10 minutes on high. And then we let it naturally release for 15 minutes. It is still under pressure, but I'm going to go ahead and flip the vent and let it vent off the rest. Quick release for the rest. Maybe I am. Yeah. There we go.
There we go. Now you're going to watch us blow off some steam.
Ah, Mikey's gonna dance.
This is taking a lot longer than I thought.
Oh, we're so used to slow cooking that, like, we're all frazzled that this is taking an extra 2 minutes.
Music break.
Why do birds suddenly appear every time? You are near.
That's not how the song goes, but that's how I remember it. I guess what this means is there was a lot of pressure in there, so that means that chicken should be really cooked well.
Let's hope.
Oh, yeah. We want this to be done.
Ah.
There it is, just like that.
Okay.
All right, now we're going to take the lid off.
Yummy.
Oh, my goodness. Hold up. Hold up. Everybody stop.
Oh, yeah.
You see... We can't really have 2 cameras going on because we're outside and the rig just won't work. So we're going to do this.
You guys.
We're going to bring you to the pot. Look at that.
Yummy.
Look at that. Oh my goodness.
And so now if you want to break up your chicken, you can take 2 forks in there and start shredding up your chicken.
Why would you want to mess up the chicken like that? I'd like the big old chunks.
Well, you're not the only
people.
But see how tender that is? And that is from frozen.
Oh my goodness.
That's so lovely. All those, and the noodles held up just great.
Mm-hmm.
I love that you don't have to have an extra step with them.
I like that the pepperoncinis don't just give flavor, but look at the color that gives in there.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Oh, ow, that's hot.
By the way, it's hot too.
Okay, so put it back so you can taste it.
okay.
He likes taping these shows before we feed everybody because that means he actually gets to eat before his guests.
Before we go on, I think the neighbor's grill might be on fire. I'm just saying. Look at that.
All right, Mikey. Give it the true Mississippi taste test. Careful. Don't lift that up because it's hot.
Is it? Well, here, I'll lift it from the not hot end. Ooh, nope, it's all hot end.
Yes.
I'm going to put it back on the table. Get some chicken. Oh, that chicken is fall apart tender.
I am so excited. I can't believe that's only 10 minutes under pressure. That is awesome. From frozen, everything.
Those noodles, they feel like they're done.
Yes. And they've got, do they have the Mississippi flavor?
I don't know yet. I haven't even blown on it. I would blow on this because it's hot. That is good. That is chicken and noodles, y'all. That is Mississippi chicken and noodles. Oh, my gosh.
In southern Indiana, even.
Oh, man.
What do you think?
Okay. So I put 7 pepperoncinis in there. Not as hot as you would think because there was a lot of liquid going on there. You've got the liquid that was in the chicken. You've got the broth. It's going to kind of, you know, lessen that heat, but there's still just a tinge of heat on the back end. Now, if I was to eat that with one of those pepperoncinis, I'd probably get some more heat with that. But it adds that sour flavor. But then you got those noodles. Now, they were frozen. The chicken was frozen. We cooked it for a very short amount of time, 10 minutes.
Under pressure. It took a while to get to pressure.
Yeah, it gets up to pressure, so it cooks on the way up. And then it cooks it for that temperature. And then it comes down over 15 minutes on that natural release. And then we release it the rest of the way. So I'd say it was up to get to pressure about 10 minutes, and then another 15. So that's 10, 20, 35 minutes, plus the time that we took to vent.
It could be more depending on your unit and also depending on your altitude.
It'll be less than an hour, and oh my gosh.
Comfort food, great for the holidays.
Those noodles are al dente. That's where you want your noodles. Don't fall apart in your mouth. They're not mushy. They're chewy like a noodle should be. I don't want to talk to you anymore.
Well, if you guys like this video, we'd love for you to give us a thumbs up. And if you are not already a member of the Crock Posse, please click subscribe down below. And you become a member of our slow cooking, multi-cooking, pressure cooking, and foodie cooking family.
So far, the foodie is a goodie.
We would love for you to also click the bell down below. We call it the ding-a-ling.
Ding-a-ling.
To get notifications for when we do post videos on here. But whatever you do, we hope that you
laugh often.
Eat good food.
And speak life.
Bye, guys.
Bye. Oh, my gosh. Okay. That is so good. Hey, y'all. Today, me and Cris. Cris and I are making Mississippi chicken. Dang it.
Come on, Foodi. Show them your foodie.
Just not my booty.
No! Sorry. You gotta open this muscle.
That grill is on fire. That grill is on fire. If you want to see the latest, click on the left right here. If you feel like subscribing, click on the right, my dear. And if you think we're funny enough to send us money, click the Patreon.